Welcome, everyone. Our topic for this video will be on creating new dashboards in LogInsight Cloud, populating them, and modifying them. While the out-of-the-box dashboards in LogInsight Cloud are very powerful, sometimes an administrator has unique needs for their environment. In that case, we can create our own dashboards to model just the data we need to see. So let's start by creating our new dashboard by going to the Dashboard section. Let's click this New Dashboard button. We'll give the dashboard a name. Storage issues. We created a query for smart errors in our Basics of Log Explorer video, so let's look for that saved query. Here's our smart errors. We'll add this widget to the dashboard, and that'll populate. Now I created another query for SCSI sense warnings, storage sense codes. Let's create another widget for vSAN errors over time. So now we have a dashboard with three widgets. We have our vSAN error events over time, storage sense issues, and smart errors. Now let's say we want to change the visualization about one of these. We can just click this. We can make it a trend. Now we can see if things are trending up or down. Let's clean this up a little. Right, now we have a dashboard called Storage Issues with a few different widgets. We have two line graphs, and we have a small window that shows us our trend of events for vSAN errors. We'll change this to the latest 24 hours, and let's save this. All right, now we have a new dashboard. Go to our Dashboard section. Private dashboard called Storage Issues. Now we can view, we can clone, we can change the access control. So let's change the roles that have access to this. So we'll give our demo user access to this dashboard. So they can read this dashboard, but they cannot change it. Now we can also add a tag to our dashboard. Let's add a tag called Storage Operations. All right, so now we have that tag. So now if we filter by tag, so now we filtered by storage operations, and our storage issues dashboard comes up. We can add this to our favorites list. This dashboard is now in our favorites, along with my personal dashboard. And now that we've drilled into our dashboard, we can see our widgets, and we can do some troubleshooting. So it looks like we have some vSAN errors that are trending up about disk access, device resource are busy, and then we can see our smart errors and our storage sense codes. So we can extrapolate from this data that there might be something going on with our storage environment. So then we can always just dig in a little further. If we want, we can view our log query and interactive analysis, and we can see all the events that are trending for this time. Then we can see all the events that have come up for this time period, and then we can do our troubleshooting from here in the Log Explorer and make some changes. So it looks like our issues started happening a little before April 21st. So we might want to dig a little deeper, see what happened to our storage environment during that time, and get the storage team involved. So as you can see, the dashboards in LogInsight Cloud are pretty flexible and pretty dynamic. You can create dashboards based on any of the data you're ingesting and organize it in a way that's useful to you, whether that's via a graph, whether that's via alert, or whether it's via trends or any other way you think is useful to organize your data. So please go out and start creating your own dashboards, and thanks for watching.